Hey, what's up guys? Nuno here. In today's video, I want to show you some simple things you can do in Photoshop to increase the realism of your 3D renders. So this will be some small details that we'll add to the render, and these small details will add a little bit of more humanization to your render. It just takes about 5 to 10 minutes to add all of this, and it really increases the realism of your render. But before we start, I want to let you know that I have a free training called My Top 10 Secrets to Achieve Realistic 3D Renders. I'll leave a link in the top right corner and in the description below this video. So without further ado, let's get started. So in this video, I'll show you how you can increase the realism of your render just by adding some small details in Photoshop. So first, head over to this site, it's called textures.com. And here, as I told you before, you can create a free account. With this free account, you have 15 credits that you can use daily. So here, I'm just going to type decals. And it will show up a lot of these decals that you can use, you can download. But on the left side, you also have here decals. And I prefer to use this on the left side because here you have categorized by bottom, damage, leaking, rust spots, etc. So let's go here to the bottom. And now here you can see that a lot of this already come without the background, which is great. So we can use it immediately in Photoshop without having any extra work. And if I click on this one, you can see that they have a lot of different resolutions. And the free ones are usually the small ones, but for what we are going to do, the small ones works perfectly. We don't need more than that. And so I already downloaded a couple of these from the bottom, from leaking as well. It's very important, these ones. And I'm going to show you how you can increase the realism on your renders now in Photoshop with these textures. So here I have my render. And the first thing I'm going to do is to go here and just drag and drop from your folder the texture. It will show up like this. Just press enter. And now I'm going to actually press Ctrl T again to move it. Press enter. I'm going to place this one. This is a bottom one. I'll place it about here. Actually going to increase just a little bit more. And to fix the perspective, we can click right click and go here and distort. And now just move this one slightly up about here. Try to line up this more or less. Okay, like this is fine. But now this part is on top of the bike and on top of this box as well. So I have here my color map. This is why it's important to, let me show you this first, to have the color map when you are rendering. So you have to select this one, because like this, it helps you to do some small adjustments in Photoshop easily. So let me go back here. And now I can just go here. I'll select this bike and this box as well. Now I'm just going to click this eye icon to deselect, and I'm going to go select this one. And I have to go here to select this marching ants again. And I'm just going to right click and select inverse. And now with this texture selected, I can simply go here and add layer mask. Click. Okay, so now we don't have on top of the bike, neither on the box. Now we're going to select this and put multiply. And so for this one, you see that it adds a little bit more of this moss here. You can go here to the fill and try to reduce a little bit to match a little bit to the background. But actually for this one, I like it at 100%. Okay, let's go back. For example, this part, if you have a tree next to the building for a long time, maybe it will start to have some dirt here. So I got some from this leakage area, and I'm going to place it here, about here. And again, I'm just going to the mask and I'm going to mask out this part. So just going to select inverse and make the mask the same way we did before. Okay. And now I'm going to put this as multiply. And with this mask selected, now I'm going to the brush tool here. And with a large brush, with a softness at actually the hardness at 0%, I'm going to start to erase some of these areas. You can use your numpad to type in 100, 10, 10, 20, and it will start showing here, changing here the opacity, like 35, 50. So I'm always using this, so 100% to first remove a lot. Then I put it at about 20% and add back a little bit. And now you can press X on the keyboard to swipe between black and white. And so the white will add and the black will erase. So let's just on some parts, so it's a little bit more uneven, the color. So not everything is completely dark. And another thing I'm going to do, I'm going to go here and add UV saturation and press Alt. Press Alt. Let's zoom back. So it just affects this mask, this layer here. And I'm going to increase the lightness and the saturation so I see well what I'm doing. And actually, I have to press colorize. Now, lightness and saturation. Okay, now you see that it's giving some color. So I'm going to give it like a brownish color. And a little darker. Okay, so before and after. So if you feel that this is still a little bit too much, you can go here and on this fill, just reduce a little bit. Out here, I think it's fine. Let's see it without and with. Okay, that's looking good. Now, let's go here to add one more. Let's go to the leaking and add this one. And this one is all red. Why? Because I place it on bottom of this part, so I need to move it up. And now I can just Alt and make this to the bottom again. So now it's fixed. Now let's add on this area here. And try to match the best that line there and go to distort, move it up. If you hold shift, it will just move this vertically. So try to maintain the perspective. For this one, I'll put it at multiply and I'll reduce already the fill just a little bit. About here, it's fine. I'll add again the mask and I'll erase some of it. So it's not on every part of the building. And I'm going to duplicate the same one. And I'm going to place it about here. Now I'm going to erase this part so it's less visible there. And a little bit here as well. Okay, let's see before and after. Before and after. So you see that starts to add a little bit of these details to the building and gives an idea that it's already a little bit wear. So actually we can add one here, just slightly, like so. Well, actually it should be like this. And now with the distort, we move this down, holding shift. Okay, and now just multiply. And on this one, I want just very slightly effect and just in some areas. Okay, actually, you see that this is too much on this area, so I'm going to reduce a little bit more. Okay, now another thing, if you have usually a tree for a couple of years right next to the building, it will start to create some dirt, right? So on this area, I'm going to add this one and about here, let's line up. And now let's go to the distort again, shift and shift. And just hold like this, Okay. So it's a little bit distorted, but it doesn't matter because it's just to give some color here, some dirt on this area. So multiply, and let's just first erase this bottom part here. Okay. Now erase a little bit here because it's too dark. Make it a little bit more, even more random. Okay, I think this looks good. All of this has to be subtle. If you put this effect really, really strong, yeah, I think it will kind of break the idea of this, which is just to give an extra detail on top of the render. Another thing we can do, we can go back to the website, and here, let's search for graffiti. So you can see you have a lot of graffitis here that you can select. And I already downloaded a couple of these, and I'll load here this one. Okay, now we need to go here, right click and rasterize. And now we need to press Control I, so it inverts. And now let's make it multiply and press Control L, so it loads up the levels. And let's push it till we don't see that frame. Okay. Press Control U for the saturation, because if I increase, you see that's too red. So let's just decrease a little bit. About 40% is fine. And now let's move this down to about here. And let's reduce the fill just a little bit. And lastly, another thing I want to show you, it's this area here. Even though it's the same glass as this one and as this one, it didn't get any reflections. So one simple thing we can do, we can just go here and with this mask, select this window. And now select this render. And press Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V. Now we can move this. Actually, first let's delete this part. And let's increase a little bit this. Place it like this. And now let's go back here and select this glass. And now here, with this marching ants, you press the mask. Okay. And let's change it to screen. And now we can change the opacity, lower a little bit, about here, it's fine. And so without and with. So it's just a slight change, but it really gives this glass look that you didn't have anything before. And now you can see that it's a glass. And so now if I select all of this and place it in a group, if I hide this, you see that all of this starts to add a little bit more to the render, right? And this is just some small things that you can add. And of course, don't forget that to have this realism, you have to have as well these proper textures. And if you want to know how to create these realistic PBI materials, I also have a video for that. I'll leave a link in the top right corner and in the description below this video. And so these things takes what, about 5 to 10 minutes to add them. And they really add a little bit of extra detail to your render. And that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, you know what to do. Give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and click the bell button to get notified when I publish my new videos. And before you leave, don't forget you can sign up for my free Lumion training. I'll leave a link in the top right corner and in the description below this video. And I'll see you in the next video.